Certified ethical hacker, what is it? Let's talk about it. Stay tuned. Yo, what's going on YouTube? This is Zach with IT Career Questions, and today we are talking about the CEH, which is the Certified Ethical Hacker. It's a certification that you can get from EC Council. So let's go into some of the details about it so we can see if it's something that is interesting to you. So as you can see on the screen here, a certified ethical hacker is a skilled professional who understands and knows how to look for weaknesses and different vulnerabilities within an environment. You utilize these type of hacking skills in a lawful manner. So you know how to be a malicious hacker, but you go through this process so that you can be an ethical hacker. You know how to be a malicious hacker. So you know how to hack things, you know how to be malicious, but you use all those skills and the knowledge that you know about hacking to help environments, to help secure things. That's what a certified ethical hacker is kind of all about. The CEH is brought to you by EC Council. We'll have a link to them in the description below. We'll have a few different links. So make sure you guys go check out the description for all the different links about the CEH and EC Council as well. So for the CEH certification, there is a prerequisite. You either have to have 2 years of work experience in the information security field, or you could take the official training through EC Council, and that would qualify you to actually take the CEH exam. So 2 years experience or go through the official training. There is a price difference in the two based on which path you go down. If you don't go through the official training, it does cost more money. Again, for more information, there is a link in the description below, so make sure you check that out as well. Now, before we go any further into this video, there are two different CEH exams. There's the CEH ANSI, which is the ANSI, and there's also the CEH Practical. We'll talk a little bit about each one of those. So let's get into the regular CEH exam. It's a 4-hour exam. There's 125 questions. The cost is going to range anywhere between like $900 and $1,100. Again, that's based on whether you take their certified training or you have the experience to go ahead and take that certification test on your own. There may be other discounts and things out there that you could find, so that price will fluctuate a little bit. There's also a $100 application fee that you have to pay no matter what, so be aware of that as well. The validity of this exam is 3 years, meaning once you are CEH certified, that certification is valid for only 3 years. If you want more information on the CEH ANSI, you can see a link in the description. The CEH Practical Exam. This is a 6-hour exam and it has 20 challenges. These are hands-on challenges that you have to go through during this exam process. The cost is between $900 and $1,100 or so, again, based on different discounts, training options, and things like that. The validity of this certification is also 3 years. Something else to mention about the CEH Practical is that you cannot take this practical exam unless you already have taken the CEH ANSI. So what's the big difference between the CEH ANSI and the CEH Practical? As we said previously, the CEH ANSI is 125 questions, a 4-hour long test, versus the practical, which is a 6-hour long test, and it's all hands-on. Biggest difference between these two certifications is the practical actually shows that you have the skills to become a CEH. It's not that the CEH ANSI doesn't show you those skills, it's the fact that the regular CEH ANSI is just a 125 question test. So you can study for that all day long and go ahead and pass it. But with the CEH practical, you have to study, you have to understand how these things work, and you have to know how to actually complete some of these different commands, processes, and things that are related to the CEH exam. The CEH practical is a 20 challenge exam. So you have 6 hours to complete these 20 challenges that are going to actually throw you into a real world type of environment in a scenario, and you have to complete what they're looking for you to do. Again, you have to have the CEH ANSI to complete the CEH practical. So what will you learn as a CEH? We're gonna go over some of these, but we will provide a full list of these in the description below, so make sure you check that out. You're gonna learn key issues plaguing the information security world, incident management process, and penetration testing. That says a lot right there within itself. You'll also learn about different types of Trojans, Trojan analysis and Trojan countermeasures, working of viruses, virus analysis, computer worms, malware analysis, procedure and countermeasures, packet sniffing techniques and how to defend against sniffing, social engineering techniques, identity theft and social engineering countermeasures, DOS and DDoS attack techniques, botnets, DDoS attack tools, and DOS, DDoS countermeasures. And here's another continuation of everything you'll learn, again, provided in the link in the description below. Session hijacking techniques and countermeasures, SQL injection attacks and injection detection tools, wireless encryption, wireless hacking methodology, wireless hacking tools, and Wi-Fi security tools, different threats to IoT platforms, and learn how to defend IoT devices securely. So we just touched on a few of these, but you can see that there is a very broad range of things that you need to know and understand to go through the Certified Ethical Hacker testing and exam. So if you guys want to learn how to do some of this stuff, you can find training resources online where they can provide their own labs and you go through some different simulations there. But I highly suggest you build your own labs and you try to build some of your own simulations and you try to understand this stuff as well. There are a lot of great resources out there like Hack the Box. There's a couple different ones that I can provide in the link in the description. They're free resources, but they can show you how to utilize some of these different things that you need to learn. So what kind of CEH jobs are out there? And this is kind of a rough list. Bear in mind that once you get your CEH, this will only help elevate you during your career. So you can be an ethical hacker, of course. You can be a penetration tester, a threat intelligence analyst. You can become a security analyst. And the reason why I have the asterisks there is because there are many job roles out there with the name security analyst in them. So you might see a few different variations of security analyst out there. And a prerequisite to many other high-level jobs that would also require certifications like the CISO or the CISP, they also require that you have the CEH. So if you're looking to go down that route towards CISO or towards the CISP, you may also have to have your CEH for some of the different jobs that require that. So there are many jobs out there that actually do require the CEH certification, so keep that in mind. So the CEH salary on average in the United States is around $90,000 per year. That's a pretty hefty salary. So if you are interested in making that kind of money, the CEH could be something that would work out well for you. So in closing in this video, this was just a brief video to kind of introduce you to what a certified ethical hacker is. Again, there's more links in the description that can give you more information. But just to give you a rundown of the CEH, of the Certified Ethical Hacker, this is a certification that will take a lot of time in studying and understanding. Again, it's highly suggested that you go through different labs, whether they're simulated labs, whether you create your own home lab. You need to understand how some of these different processes work. This isn't exactly a certification that you should go to right off the bat. It's not something that you should start out with by any means. It is suggested that you learn a lot of the different fundamentals within IT. So whether that's you taking your A+, your NET+, Security+, having some of that fundamental knowledge before you go after your CEH is definitely advisable. Don't think by any means that going out and getting your CEH is going to guarantee you any type of job right off the bat, especially if that's the only certification you have and you have no experience or no degree. Make sure you have fundamental knowledge, because once you go through this exam, if you don't have that, a lot of this stuff is going to be really hard to understand. And of course, you could take that regular CEH exam and you can go through those 125 questions and you can pass it, but that doesn't mean that you know the material from that exam. You may have never applied that in real life and you may not understand some of the fundamentals that you really need to know to understand the CEH completely. The Certified Ethical Hacker certification is definitely a very sought after certification in the security world, and it is definitely advisable as one of the best certifications to get if you're looking to go down that security route. If you're looking to be a pen tester, security analyst, this certification is definitely for you. You can go check out EC Council's website where they have more information there. You can look and see what type of training resources they have there. And you can look at how you can enroll to become a certified ethical hacker. If you guys have any more questions about the CEH, you want me to go more into detail, we can definitely do that in another video. I'm going to be bringing on somebody here shortly that is actually CEH certified, who can give us some more insight in what it is actually like to become a certified ethical hacker. The whole point of this video is just to give you this brief overview of what the CEH is. I hope you found this useful. I hope this information really worked for you. If you have any comments, questions, or concerns, be sure to hit me up in the comments below. As always, I'm always happy to help you guys and answer whatever questions that I can. If I don't have the answers for you, I'm going to bring an expert on this show so they can share their real-world knowledge or real-world experience in whatever that question you have may be. So as always, take it easy.